Hi Rod, we've just started our social marketing efforts and I wanted to know how we can get more followers on Twitter and Facebook.
Hey James, let's make a deal. You follow us, we'll follow you. AOL Small Biz on Twitter. It's great to see companies exploring Twitter more and more. We heard from an entrepreneur recently who said it's the single greatest marketing tool a small business can have. You know, some companies have seen a lot of success with it. For some, it's just kind of a time waster. But it's great to explore and see how it can work, especially in the retail world. So in terms of getting more followers, I think you want to create content in 140 characters or less that's compelling. You want to give people a reason to follow you. And I think the reason why a lot of retailers have found success with this is people are very brand loyal. If there's a company or a retailer that they love shopping at, they love working with, they literally want to follow you. They want to know what's going on with the company. And a lot of companies struggle with, should I be tweeting about, you know, my personal life? Should I be tweeting about sales and promotions? And the answer is sort of all of the above. It's frankly something I struggled with when I first got on Twitter. And I realized you just have to be yourself. I think authenticity is so important with Twitter. And people don't like to follow a company and just get hit over the head with promotions and sales and things like that. At the same time, they don't want to know what the boss is having for lunch every single day, that kind of thing. So it's finding that balance, giving your Twitter feed some personality, and really giving people a reason to check out what's going on. The other advice I would say is you want to interact with your customers over Twitter. You want to follow them if they're doing something interesting. You want to reach out to them if they say something nice about your company, you know, ping them on Twitter. If they say something, you know, they have a complaint, they weren't happy with something, reach out to them again and say, you know, we're going to try to do it next time. Maybe offer them a coupon or a special. So I think it's about maintaining it and really providing a regular source of information. If you're only planning to do it every 2 weeks, I wouldn't waste your time, but if you really want to jump in all the way. Let's dip into the Ask Rod mailbag. We've got an email here from Paul, and he writes, I have an incredible pepper spice that is good on all foods, just don't know how to get it out there on the shelves of grocery stores. Maybe you can help give me direction on where to go with this. Most people wish they could invent a product. I believe I have the pepper spice that has what it takes. Hope you can help. Paul, there is your slogan right there. You have the pepper spice that has what it takes. A great slogan helps, certainly. I think with the food industry, I've covered a lot of food and beverage companies, often because I get free samples out of it. But it's a really fun industry, and I think it's become so niche that there are so many smaller companies out there that there really is room on the shelves of places like Whole Foods for a lot of unique entrepreneurial brands. So I think it's about creating a good story, a good brand, obviously good packaging that sort of conveys all that's good about your pepper spice. You say it's good on all foods. I wonder if it's good on ice cream. But, you know, it sounds like you've got a product that has a kind of a wide application. So it's about creating that story, and I would suggest if it's kind of a gourmet thing, maybe try to get it on the shelves of smaller specialty markets, maybe local ones, that you can kind of do a test run and show the popularity of it, because a place like Whole Foods, some of the bigger supermarkets, places like that, they want to see a track record. They want to know that you've got something that has resonated with consumers, that you can fulfill demand, that kind of thing. They're going to be that much more willing to give you a shot if you've started local and kind of grown it from there. So you hear me talk about it a lot. Things tend to snowball in business, and I think it's a case of just getting it out there, kind of building a buzz, maybe getting some media attention, and spicing up life.
Rod or Rob?
Rod, with a D.
D, right.